Okay, I will read Isaiah 43:18. The Bible says, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. May the Lord bless his word. I want to share about a new beginning. I want to share about a new beginning. And I know we are not in the start of the year, but number 8, which is the month we are in, signifies new beginning. August is 8th, and 8th means a new beginning. God created the world, did everything for 6 days. On the 7th day, he rested. On the 8th day, he began a new cycle. So 8 means a new beginning. Tell your neighbor you're going to have a new beginning. I didn't hear. Look at a neighbor. Say, neighbor, you're going to have a new beginning. Father, we thank you for this moment that you've given to us. Lord, we are praying as you usher us into this month of new things. Give us a new beginning. We thank you and we bless you. In Jesus' name we pray. Can somebody shout and say amen? Amen. Look at a neighbor again, say, a new beginning is coming your way. Let me just go straight to my message. And I wanted to understand that new beginning is a promise that we are given by God. He says, behold, I will do a new thing. It is a promise that we are given by God. Therefore, we can say that the God that we serve is a God of new beginnings. Praise the name of the Lord. He is a God of new beginnings. We serve a God of new beginnings. And this God of new beginnings has given us a promise of a new beginning. That is the reason why I can confidently tell you, you're going to have a new beginning. Which means a fresh start. Which means a new chapter. Which means to open again. Which means to experience a new thing. So when we are talking about a new beginning, something great is coming in our life in this month of August. Then understand also that new beginnings start with you. New beginnings start with you. We can decree and declare. We can pour oil on you. We can fast over your life. We can teach your word like I'm teaching powerfully. Am I teaching powerfully? And you will hear and listen, but the new beginning starts with you. It cannot be forced in your life. It has to start within you. It's something you begin, you decide from your heart and say, I am out for a new beginning. Praise the name of the Lord. So if we are talking about the keys for a new beginning, you are number one key. You hold the key yourself to experience a new beginning. Because truth be told, God can be doing something new, but you are stuck in the old and you are not experiencing the new. So you become your own stumbling block. It has to begin with you. Say, new beginning starts with me. I didn't hear you say, new beginnings starts with me. It has to start with you before it goes out. Praise the name of the Lord. You look at our religion, Christianity. It's not good to call it religion, but anyway, so that you can understand, our religion, Christianity, does not begin from outside. It begins from inside. God begins from inside. He changes you from in. Other religions start from out to in. Hello? You must dress like this so that we can know you belong. You must do like this so that we can know you belong. But in Christianity, Christ does not just begin, he does not begin from out, he begins from in. That is why you have to be very careful how you judge people. Praise the name of the Lord. Because if a prostitute walks in here and she's dressed in her regalia and she gives her life to Christ, she is born again in those clothes. It is not the clothes that make her born again. Hello? And when Christ begins to work in her life, then slowly she does begins to discover, I don't need to be dressing like this. Praise the name of the Lord. I don't need to be looking like this. Why? Because it begins from here. Praise the name of the Lord. The sad thing is that we have many people in church who are outward Christians, not inward. Can I preach it today the way I feel it? Not inward. You've not allowed Christ to work in you. And when he works in you, definitely it manifests outwardly. Praise the name of the Lord. So, the new beginning. Beginning begins with you. It begins with you. And when we learn that, we know that when we set ourselves ready, we are ready to experience the new beginning that comes from God. Praise the name of the Lord. Now, write this one down. What are the triggers for a new beginning? What are the triggers? There are things that will trigger new beginnings in your life. Number one, God's word. God's word is a good trigger for a new beginning. You cannot read God's word and you still remain stale, and you still remain old, and you still remain archaic, and you still remain old-fashioned. God's word will always bring newness in your life, will always push you into a new beginning. That's why when we came to Christ, the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5:17, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new. Hey, talk to me, he is a new. Hey, talk to me, he is a new. Hey, I cannot hear, he is a new. Now, when you keep on reading God's word, there is something that happens. Newness begins to take place in your life. Do not be conformed to the patterns of this world. But let your mind be renewed by what? By the word of God. You have to allow God to renew you, to transform you. And when the word of God comes in your life, it transforms you. It brings a new beginning in your life. You start thinking differently. So God's word is a trigger. You can be reading God's word and you are reading the book of Genesis, the scriptures that you've read before. All of a sudden, the Spirit of the Lord illuminates into you a secret that you had not touched before in the same scripture that you have been reading before. And it shows you a new beginning that you need to do things in a different way. My prayer that you will is that you will have such encounters that the word of the Lord will push you for a new beginning. Can I hear someone shout amen? The word of the Lord will push you to a new beginning. In fact, even when I'm preaching now, somebody's going to experience a new beginning because I'm bringing God's word. I said I'm bringing God's word. A new beginning is going to take place in your life. By the time we are done with this service, you shall be new. You shall be newer. A new chapter will already have been opened in your life. Things will be different. A new thing will already start taking place in your life. If you believe it, shout and say amen. What is trigger number two? What are triggers number two? Trigger number two that triggers new beginnings. Seasons trigger beginnings in our lives. Seasons. Of course, here we don't have all the seasons. We only have one season. That is hot, hotter, and if there's that word. So when it's hot, some people feel chilly, you know? And they say it's cold. And then it keeps increasing like that. But if you travel, you will see all these seasons. All you will experience all these seasons. Now, you will have to change your dressing when seasons are changing. True or false? Can you imagine if you're standing out with your spaghetti and it is winter, you are standing out and you're saying, freeze and shine. Truth be told, you will join the club of Lot's wife because you will freeze completely and you will not shine. You will die. Yours will be freezing and dying because you are not properly dressed. Praise the name of the Lord. And sometimes when the season changes, even the things that people do are different. The things that people do are different. I remember one day I was in this city and it had completely snowed. And we were driving and the car was skidding on the snow. And I thought, oh my, this one is gonna be dangerous for us. But the guys are used to it, so they keep changing. Now, the same road that you'll be using and cruising at 100 plus, now you cannot because a season has changed. Praise the name of the Lord. If you are expecting and you are 8 months, there are some things you don't do. True or false? Women, am I saying the truth? There's some things you don't do. Even if you are trained for pull vault jumping. Have you ever seen a pregnant woman, 8 months old, coming? It is now time to Kenya versus whatever. And I've been representing my country. Now I'm 8 months. Now I still have to represent my country with a pull vault jump. Running. Then sticks it. Then goes up. Can you picture that? And then when she comes down, lands on that big mattress, poop. Have you ever seen that? Because there are things you cannot do. When seasons change, something changes. Praise the name of the Lord. It triggers a different thing. I remember when my wife was pregnant, even her sitting changed. You know? She used to sit in a certain way when we were just enjoying ourselves. Now there is a baby. Even her sitting changes. And everything changed. Even the colognes that she wanted in the house changed. A new beginning. Seasons will trigger a new beginning. Praise the name of the Lord. Number three, circumstances can trigger new beginnings. Circumstances can trigger new beginnings. Let me go quickly because I want to really. Number four, failure. So sometimes failure is not bad. Hello? You only fail if you refuse to rise up. Because successful people are people who have failed several times. And they knew the art of rising up. So I wanted to understand, if you are here, maybe you are listening to me, I came to tell you, it is your time to rise again. It's a time for a new beginning. Praise the name of the Lord. I feel like I need to push this. You know, you have sat down, you've looked at your year, and you're saying, my year has been very hard. My year has been very bad. I came to tell you, failure triggers a new beginning. A new beginning can start today. Don't give up. A new beginning is coming your way. Praise the name of the Lord. You're saying, Pastor, we're already in the month of August. I planned, I started, and nothing has happened. I came to tell you, God does not need many months. It begins with you. If you can say tonight I'm beginning, it will begin. Can I hear an amen? It will begin. So rise up. Get out of that failure. Get out of that dust. Tell the devil enough is enough. get to God and tell him, God, it is me and me again, coming in the need of prayer. I need to come out of that situation. I need to come out of this thing because I need a new beginning. I need God to set me back on my track. And it's going to happen in your life. Praise the name of the Lord. You are here, you're saying, marriage has not worked for me. I came to tell you, that failure is not a finality. You can rise up again and start again. Praise the name of the Lord. I've seen women who they lost, their husband died. And after death, they went to the salon. They came up with hairdos that we've never seen them with. They went to the shop, bought clothes that we've never seen them with. Now they're walking and enjoying life. Because sometimes you don't need to be there forever. Praise the name of the Lord. Someone has been dumped, comes out enjoying, and now saying, I need a new lease of life. And they make it. Because failure is not the finality. Praise the name of the Lord. What is the trigger again for that? God's will. Number what? Number five, God's will is a trigger for a new beginning. The man called Saul had something he was doing, a career that he had already crafted for himself, to vex the church, to beat the children of God, to kill the Christians. But the will of God concerning his life was that he was supposed to suffer for God, and he was supposed to propel God's word. So on his way to Damascus, guess what? He collides with a divine accident. And the will of God concerning his life brought a new beginning. Praise the name of the Lord. Some of you need to collide with God's will. You've been walking and grappling and groping in darkness here and there. May the will of God come in your life. I said, may the will of God come in your life. There are people you start as doctors. You've gone to school 7 years in college, and you studied and you became a doctor. Then God comes and tells you, I've called you full time. Leave your doctoring and come and serve me. A new beginning. The will of God. Praise the name of the Lord. Hey, praise the name of the Lord. Some of you are looking at me as if you don't want me to go ahead because you feel like you don't want God to come. God can come to your career and tell you it is enough. You have served enough. Now I want you to resign. Some people are really afraid of that. Praise the name of the Lord. Hey, you have to. God's will. I've had women who vowed and said, I will never get married to a pastor. Never. So what did they do? They went and married someone in the career. And this career person kept on working. Then one day God stopped him and told him, you know what? You need to stop there. You need to come and serve me. Now they are pastors' wives. Others are bishops' wives. Hello? Can I speak this thing? Because there are some women who are really choosing here, saying, I can't. But you may never know. When the will of God is working, can I hear a big amen? Can I hear a big amen? Yeah, man, when the will of God works, you are saying, I want to be a businessman. But when the will of God hits your life, you start business A, stops. Business B, stops. Business C, stops. Business D, stops. Stops, stops. Until you tell God, God, I've surrendered. Where do you want me to go? Is it Lokichogyo? You just tell me. Is it Kainuk? You just tell me. I will do it. And when you're in the will of God, you touch one business like this, it blossoms. Praise the name of the Lord. Because you can still serve God even in business, as a businessman. Hello? You can still serve God even as a billionaire. I know people like Paul Yonggi Cho. He has elders in church who are billionaires. Elders serving. They are serving God and preaching the word of God, going with him wherever he goes, and they're still doing business.
May that be your portion.
The will of God. Can somebody say the will of God? Then the other thing that can start trigger a new beginning is a major setback. Major setback can trigger a new beginning. You are married before, now you have to be married because your husband is no more. Your wife is no more. So you go back again to start choosing. So there are major setbacks that can trigger new beginnings. Maybe you're working and something happened. Either you got an industrial accident. Now you have to learn to use the limbs that you have. A new beginning in life. My prayer is that that will not be your burden. I mean, it will not be your portion in the name of the Lord. But a setback can cause a new beginning. And lastly, a burden can trigger a new beginning. A burden. Ask your neighbor, do you have a burden? There are people who have a certain burden. You have a burden for maybe, let's say, our city. You have a burden for our city. You don't like the leadership and the way things are being done. You don't like the way things are being run. A burden gets into you. Every day you're walking, you're seeing things here. It's a burden, a burden. Then that burden nurtures you to a place where you say, I'm getting into leadership. I'm getting into the political area. I'm getting into this thing so that I can change this. So when we find you now, you have changed. Your title has changed. You are now doing things. You are now appearing in a different office. Why? Because a burden. Can somebody say a burden? A burden can trigger a new beginning. So quickly, what are the things, the keys that we need to employ to ensure we enjoy this new beginning? We have the most of this new beginning. The Bible says in Isaiah 43:18, remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. What are the keys that you should employ to maximize your new beginning? Number one, stop hanging on the past. Stop hanging on the past. Remember ye not the former things, the Bible says. Don't keep on hanging on the past. Verse 18, remember ye not. Because God wants you to forget those things. Don't keep on dwelling on the past. The past is very poisonous. The past can blind you to see your future. So it's important for you to stop hanging on the past. There are people who keep on hanging on the past. Yes, the past was what it was. Praise the name of the Lord. The future is better than your past. Can I hear an amen? How many believe that their future is better than the past? How many believe that you will do better in the future than what you did in the past? How many believe that you will have more money in the future than the money that you had in the past? How many believe that you'll have greater businesses in the future than the businesses that you had in the past? How many believe that your marriage in the future is going to be better than the way it was in the past? How many believe that your relationships in the future are going to be better than what they were in the past? How many believe that you will get to know better people than the ones that you knew in the past? In fact, I changed myself from the past to your future now, so that you don't find better ones. And I miss to be there. The past is poisonous. And we cannot keep on relying and speaking about the past. So stop hanging on the past. Praise the name of the Lord. Stop hanging on the past. The past has gone. Praise the name of the Lord. Look at the future. It is better. Look at the future. It is better. Praise the name of the Lord. Even in technology, when they were facing out things, they no longer bring them back. They no longer bring them back. But the worst thing is this, you will find that people are still hanging on things that are already outfaced. You're still hanging on it. You're still hanging on it. Me, I don't have the anointing of museum. You know the museum anointing? You want to keep things that are already discarded. You want to still keep them. Whatever is outfaced is outfaced. You leave it, you move ahead. Some of you are not saying amen. It is gone, it is gone. Number two, key that you need to have because of time. Esteem the right things. Esteem the right things. Value. Give preeminence to the right things, not the wrong things. God was so clear here when he was telling them, see, I am making a new way. He tells them, consider not the things of it. Consider not. Don't waste your mind on it. Don't moose over it. Don't keep thinking about it. Don't keep regurgitating it. You are busy. Busy having a kamkunji on the old things that have already gone. He says, don't esteem those things. The things that have gone, let them go. Praise the name of the Lord. Start thinking on the right things. Don't esteem what has gone in the past. Philippians 4:8, the Bible says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. So if you want to be a think tank, thinking, these are the characteristics of the things that you need to have to qualify what you're thinking about. One, you have to make sure that that thing is true. Praise the name of the Lord. Hey, praise the name of the Lord. You have to make sure it's true. So if we start with truth, when the teacher says you are a failure and you will die as a failure, is that true? Is that true? When your ex says you're ugly, you're stupid, you will not amount to anyone, no one is gonna love you in this earth, is it true? Is it true? We are in this earth to be loved. We are not going to heaven to be loved. So the fact that you're in this earth, you qualify. Praise the name of the Lord. When people look at you and say that you and your people are nothing, is it true? So why are you wasting your time thinking about it? Crying about it? Building hatred about it? Whatever is true, whatever is noble, it has to be noble. Whatever is right, it has to be right. Whatever is pure. Hello? Ask your neighbor, neighbor. Do you think of pure things? Whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. I know this is where we all like thinking. This is where we all like thinking. It is admirable, you know? It is excellent. It is of praiseworthy. But there are others that precede that before we come to this last three. And we need to put our mind in it. Praise the name of the Lord. You have to have that key. Key number three you need to have is the key of vision. Have a vision. Verse 19, the Bible says, see, visualize it. See, I'm doing a new thing. You must see it. You must open your mouth, your eyes to it, because what you are not seeing will never come your way. Hello? Whatever you don't travel into with your mind never comes to your life in reality. Whatever you don't travel into with your mind, it never comes into your life to be a reality. Never. So you must see it. Praise the name of the Lord. Hey, praise the name of the Lord. Ask your neighbor, neighbor, what are you seeing? In fact, let me ask, how many are seeing themselves to be millionaires? Oh, some of you are not sure about it. How many are seeing themselves as landlords? How many are seeing themselves as entering heaven? Hey, How many are seeing themselves as great soul winners? That you're bringing souls to God. You have to see it. Praise the name of the Lord. How many are seeing themselves lending to many and not borrowing? Some people are not seeing here. How many are seeing themselves failures? How many are seeing themselves as winners? You're seeing yourself as a winner. Praise the name of the Lord. We need to see ourselves the right. We need to have the right vision. Praise the name of the Lord. Because if you don't see it, it doesn't come. If you don't see it, it doesn't do what? It doesn't come. You have to see yourself as an international person before it happens in your life. You have to see yourself. You are not here, brought on this earth to be just born here. Born, you were born here at Mombasa Hospital. You went to school at Chuda Primary. After school, you went to secondary where? Star of the Sea. After Star of the Sea, you went to university, Pwani University. Then you got a digo that married you. Next to number, the place here at Mamba Village. Then you gave your birth to your child at Premier Hospital. You bought your house in Chanzo. You're working. Where? Bamburi Cement. All your friends are in Mkomani. When you're going for outing, it is where? Mtuapa. When you have to go for holiday, it is Diani. Surely. You grow old. Just here. Then you will be buried in Baraki. Hey, your life has to have a difference. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to have a vision of somewhere bigger. Praise the name of the Lord. That even though I'm here, I can do some things far away. I can see the globe. Have a global vision. Don't have a local mentality kind of vision. Have a global one. See yourself doing things. Praise the name of the Lord. How many are seeing themselves doing great things? Can I hear a big amen? You need to have a vision. Ask your neighbor, neighbor, what is your vision? I didn't hear. Tell your neighbor, I have a vision. When we ask you about winning souls, do you have a vision to win souls? Do you have that vision to bring people to the kingdom of God? Or yours is just to be there. You need to have a vision. Sit down right where you need to be. I think it was in the boot camp. I was telling people, I know what I need to do up to 50 years. I know that by the age of this 50, I should have done 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I know it. And my prayer is that I will accomplish it before I get it there. Some of you are jealous of me. You're not saying amen. My prayer is that I will accomplish it before I get it to 50. You need to have your own vision. See, you have to see it, he was telling them. You have to see. I am doing a new thing. Then he says something that I really, really love in verse 19. See, I am doing a new thing. I am doing a new thing. You need to depend on the right source for your new beginnings. I am. God now is saying, I am the one doing it. I am the one orchestrating it. I am doing a new thing. I am doing a new thing. Tell your neighbor, neighbor, I know you don't believe me, but the good thing is that I am not the one doing the new thing. It is God doing the new thing. How many are glad that it is God doing the new thing? He says, I am the one doing the new thing. I came to tell you something. Please don't give up. Don't cop out. Don't say it is not going to happen, because it is not by your strength. It is not by your power. It is not by your knowledge. It is by the Spirit of the Lord, says God Himself. God is the one doing the new thing. So when we are talking about a new beginning, you might sit down and try to look at yourself and try to measure things and try to analyze, and you say it is not going to work. It will not work because you are thinking with your own mind. But when you open your eyes on what God is about to do and what God is planning in your life, you will realize that the new beginning, it is God who is carrying it in your life, not any other man. If you believe it, shout and say amen. That is the reason why I can confidently say no one knows you, because no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has seen what the Lord has prepared for you. Today you can be here, tomorrow you can be up. Today you can be a non-entity, tomorrow you can be respected. Today you cannot be doing anything, tomorrow you can be the pushers of this world. I came to tell you, the new thing is not a figmentation of a human being, it is the pushing of the Lord. Jehovah Jireh, when He backs you, it happens in your life. When He's on top, He leads you in your life. When He's with you, He gives you the strength. You cannot fail when you have the beginner of new beginnings. He's the one that began the world. When the earth was void and without form, He said, let there be light. I'm telling you, if God speaks in your life, can you say, God speak in my life? Some of you, if God says, let there be a husband will come. Some of you, if God says, let there be money, money will come. If God says, let there be healing, healing will come. It is your time. You only need God. You only need, because when He made the earth, He was alone. And if He did all these things in 7 days, 6 days, what about you? What about you? He's going to do it in your life. Can you say, I'm about to experience a new beginning? I cannot hear. Say, I'm about to experience a new beginning. Key number what? Number six. Some of you are on four, others on five. Me, I'm on six. Number six, seek knowledge in that area that you want to see a new beginning. Master the area for the new beginning. Master it. Verse 19. Master it. God is asking, shall ye not know it? Will you not know it? You have to know it. You have to master it. Praise the name of the Lord. Tell your neighbor, master it. Seek knowledge in that area that you want for the new beginning. Seek knowledge. Seek knowledge. Some of you are crying and telling God, God, promote me, promote me, promote me. In the name of Jesus, promote me. Have you studied what it entails to get into that new office? Have you mastered what you need in that new office? Or you think you'll be speaking in tongues in that new office and you'll be getting results? Maybe you need to go and get another master's. Maybe you need to go back and add something on your certificate. Maybe you need to do a short course here and there. Maybe you need to study what needs to be done in that new office so that God can open the new office. Hello? You cannot just be praying, Father, Father, I command, let my husband come from the north in the name of Jesus. Come from the south in the name of Jesus. Now that is confusion. Come from the east. Come on in north, back in north. Come from the east in the name of Jesus. Come from the west in the name of Jesus. You've called him even from above. I call you from above. Now, let's forget the ignorance in the prayer. You are praying for the husband. Have you studied what it means to take care of a husband? Have you studied? Hello? Father, I command, give me a wife in the name of Jesus. In fact, that one I've seen. Lord, I decree and declare. Let her be blind and deaf to every other man, but see me alone in the name of Jesus. Now you are praying those kind of prayers. Have you studied what it means to keep a woman in your house? Because she doesn't eat tongues. Are there women in the house? I was told women love good things. Hello? You cannot just be commanding and you don't know what it entails. Praise the name of the Lord. You need to take time. One day I was listening to Smith Wills. Will Smith. I'm used to Smith Wigglesworth. Smith Wills. Wills. Will. And he said, when the marriage was in tumbles, he went and studied. He bought 50 books on marriage. 50. When he married counselor, I told you, I saw my mother. Where were? You are the one counseling people. You died so much. 50. Not to be a counselor, to salvage, to know how do I deal. How do I, Yusuf, how? It does not come by karabazagarabori baradede. Because they don't, these ones don't understand that. There has to be a certain kind of knowledge. That is why the Bible says, love her with knowledge. Haven't you read that part of the scripture? Love her with knowledge. With what? With what? With what? Can I give you one knowledge? Amma, let me just leave it. Let me just leave it. You need to love with knowledge. Knowledge. Understand. Know. And it will help you. You have to master the area you are going, the new beginning you are getting into. Praise the name of the Lord. Hey, praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Your marriage can see a new beginning. It does not need to go down to the drains. It only takes you to take time. Ask yourself in this area, what should I do? What should I do? How should I do it? Learn it. Go for it. And you will see the blessing of the Lord coming in your life like never before. Praise the name of the Lord. Father, give me a car. I command in the name of Jesus. Have you gone to the driving school? Have you gone to the driving school? So that when it comes, you know. Hello? Hey, hello? Make me a millionaire. Yes, he's gonna make it. But have you studied the habits of millionaires? Have you studied? Or you think when they just get money, the first thing they do is to go eat. Now I have millions. You call people. Nyaji, you call. Have you seen Chris Kirubi calling people? I'm looking for someone to buy lunch for. Hello? You have to understand some things. He says, check it out. Know it. So that when I release it in your life, it's a great thing. It will not be to some people, a blessing can end up being a curse. Do you know that? And to others, it will remain a blessing. Can I give you an example? If God blesses you, and that thing that He's blessed you with is not drawing you closer to Him, He's taking you away. It is becoming a curse. Away from the blessing that God has for you. But if the blessing that God has brought is taking you closer to God, it is a blessing. You've known how to use the blessing. Can I hear an amen? So it is important for you to know you need to do that. I need to get out of your way. I need to get out of your way. So quickly, what are the benefits of a new beginning? Number one, restoration. Restoration. The Bible says clearly, behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Can you imagine? Streams from a wasteland. God is going to bring streams from a wasteland, a land that is wasted. All what God is doing is bringing restoration. I came to speak to someone today. If your land is wasted and you're saying, I am like this wasteland, I have wasted, it's wasted completely, I want to tell you something. Please don't give up. There are streams that are coming from that wasteland. I said there are streams that are coming from that wasteland. A place where people have deserted and said nothing shall come out of it. God is saying from that particular place, I am bringing streams from a wasteland. I am bringing streams. God will restore in areas that are wasted. Anywhere that you wasted and you said it has gone, I came to tell you, this month, remember, a new beginning has come. God is restoring back. Can you say, I'm receiving my restoration? I cannot hear. Can you say, I'm receiving my restoration? If you are there to receive your restoration, I decree and declare, receive it. I said, receive it. I said, receive it. I want to close. I say, receive it. Number two, he says of the same thing, rivers in the desert. God is going to give provision in areas where there are no provision. Rivers, God is providing. God is providing. So there is provision. I came to tell you there is provision. God is giving you provision. I cannot hear an amen. God is giving someone a provision. And you need to open up your mouth to thank God for the provision that is bringing in the month of August in your life. When beginnings begin to take place, restoration, provision takes place in your life. I speak provision for you. I said I speak provision for you. I said I speak provision in your life. Where nothing was happening, God is sending supernatural provision. May you receive it in the name of Jesus. It is yours. It is yours. It does not belong to any man. And you know what? When he brings a new beginning, what you receive, thank you, is a new testimony. Write a new testimony. I came to tell you there is a new testimony. There is a new testimony. What you've just been seeing, you will not just see it, you will have it. This side is not believing me. Let me come this other side. What you've just been seeing, you will not just see it, you will have it. Because people have been testifying in that area. You are not testifying. You're just seeing what God has been doing to someone else. I came to tell you today, with a new beginning in your life, you will receive a testimony. I said you will receive a testimony. You will testify with your own mouth of what God has done, because a new beginning has taken place in your life. Tell your neighbor, a new beginning. Look at a neighbor, a new beginning. And this new beginning does not begin any other day. It begins today. Today. We are not looking for tomorrow. Today. One of the keys I didn't tell you is the key of acting now. I don't have time. Because it says now. See. Now. The God that we serve is a God of now. So you don't need to wait for tomorrow. It is happening now. Praise the name of the Lord. I want you to stand up on your feet in the name of the Lord. It is happening in your life. If only you understand that it is your season for a new beginning. Look at a neighbor, say, neighbor, it is your season for a new beginning. This is your time for a new beginning. 8 means new beginning. And new beginnings are taking place in our lives today. Lift up your hands. I want you to talk to God. To talk